Namaskar, myself Pratik. In this session, we will discuss the concept of functional dependence. Let us start this session. In order to understand the concept of functional dependence, let us consider a relation R having two attributes X and Y. And if for each value of X, there is only one value of Y, then Y is called functionally dependent on X. So in simple words, here we have a relation R having two attributes X and Y. And if for each value of X, here we have to check each value of X. And if for each value of X, there is only one value of Y, then Y is called functionally dependent on X. And it is represented as X pointer to Y. Here X is called determinant, while Y is called determined. So here X is determinant and Y is determined. In simple word, here X functionally determines Y, or Y is functionally determined by X. So here we are talking about a relation R which has two attributes X and Y. And in order to check functional dependence between these two attributes, we have to verify each value of X. And if for each value of X, there is only one value of Y, then Y is called functionally dependent on X. So the important point is that for each value of determinant, that is X in this case, for each value of determinant, there should be associated one and only one value of the determined, which is Y. So for each value of X, there should be associated one and only one value of Y. In order to understand this concept further, let us take this example. Here we have a relation student with three attributes: roll number, name and class. You can see that roll number is unique. Roll number 1 has name Raj, with class information as BE. Similarly, this is the detail of roll number 2, 3 and so on. Now in this case, we have to look for functional dependence among these attributes. Now let us consider the case of roll number and name, and let's check that whether we have this functional dependence or not. In order to check this, we have to look for each value of roll number. So here we have 7 value of roll numbers. And for each value of roll number, we should have one value of name. For roll number 1, there is only one value of name, that is Raj. For roll number 2, again there is one value of name, that is Ramesh. Since roll number is unique, so for each value of roll number, we will get only one value of name. So we can say that in this case, roll number will functionally determine name. Now let us give a thought about functional dependence between roll number and class. Now here, for each value of roll number, we are getting only one value of class. Since roll number is unique, so there is no chance of getting multiple values of classes for a given roll number. For roll number 1, class is BE. For roll number 2, again it is BE. For roll number 3, it is MCA. So you can see that for each roll number, like 1, 2, 3 and so on, you are getting only one value of class. So for each value of roll number, we are getting only one value of class. So we can say that roll number functionally determining class in this case. Now let us give a thought about name to roll number functional dependence. Now let's check that whether for a given name, we have single value of roll number or multiple value of roll number. Now first name is Raj. Now let us check that for Raj, how many roll number we have. So you can see that for Raj, we have two values of roll number. One is 1 and another is 5. For a given value of name, we are getting multiple values of roll number. So name to roll number is not functionally determined. Because for functional dependence between name to roll number, for each value of name, we should have only one value of roll number. But in this case, when name is Raj, we are getting multiple roll numbers. So that's why name to roll number is not functionally determined. Now can you answer me the functional dependence between class to roll number? is class functionally determining roll number or not? Now you can clearly see that when class is BE, we are getting multiple values of roll number, that is 1, 2, 4 and 5. So class is also not functionally determining roll number. In this case, roll number is functionally determining name and roll number is also functionally determining class. But name to roll number and class to roll number is not true. So name is not functionally determining roll number. Class is also not functionally determining roll number. Only roll number is determining name and class, because roll number is unique in this case. In order to understand this concept further, let us consider this relation R having two attributes A and B. Let us give a thought about functional dependence between A to B. Is A functionally determining B in this case or not? Now, for this we have to check each value of A. And if for each value of A, we have only one value of B, then we will say that A functionally determining B. So let's do this. So if A is 1, B is 1. If A is 2, we have two records for this. So if A is 2, B is 4. For both the cases, the value of B is same. So I can still say that when A is 2, B is 4. So the value of B is still 1. So this satisfies the case of functionally determinants. When A is 3, B is 9. When it is 4, it is 16. For 7, it is 9. So I can still say that for each value of A, there is only one value of B. So A functionally determining B in this case. Now, can you identify the functional dependence between B to A? In this case, we have to check each value of B. And for each value of B, there should be only one value of A. If B is 1, then A is 1. If B is 4, then A is 2. If B is 9, A is 3 and 7. So when B is 9, we are getting multiple values of A. So B to A is not functionally determined, while A to B is functionally determined in this case. So we can conclude that in this example, A is functionally determining B, because for each value of A, we are getting only one value of B. While B is not functionally determining A, because when B is 9, we are getting multiple values of A, that is 3 and 7. Let us consider this relation R having two attributes A and B. Now in this example, let us give a thought about the functional dependence between A to B and B to A. You have to identify whether A is functionally determining B or B is functionally determining A in this case. Take your time and solve this. After solving this, you can compare your solution with the solution discussed next in this video session. Let us give a thought about the functional dependence between A to B. In order to check this functional dependence, we have to see that for each value of A, there should be only one value of B. When A is 1, B is 1. When A is 2, the value of B is 4. When A is 3, we have multiple values of B, that is 9 and 10. So you can see that here for a given value of A, we are getting multiple values of B. So in this example, A is not functionally determining B. Now let us give a thought about functional dependence between B to A. Here you can clearly see that B is unique. It means that for each value of B, there is only one value of A. Because B cannot repeat, so there is no chance of getting multiple values of A for a given value of B. So in this example, A is not functionally determining B, while B is functionally determining A.
Thus, from this discussion, we can conclude that if we have unique value of X, then it will functionally determine Y. But if we have a repeated value of X, just as in this case of A, then we have to check for each of its value that it should have only one value, of corresponding attribute.
Let us consider this example of S table. Here we have four attributes: S number, S name, city and status. S number is the primary key of S table, and you can see that here we have a unique value of supplier number, that is S1, S2, S3 and S4. S name can repeat, two supplier can have the same name. City can repeat, multiple supplier can belong to the same city, and we have multiple values of status also. So here S number is unique. Now try to give a thought about the functional dependence between S number to S name, city and status. Since S number is unique, so it will functionally determine supplier name, because for each value of supplier number we can get only one value of supplier name. Same way, supplier number is also functionally determining city, because supplier number is unique, so there is no chance of getting multiple cities for a given supplier number. This is also true for supplier number to status. So you can clearly see that supplier number is functionally determining supplier name, city and status in this case. Now try to give a thought about the functional dependence between supplier name and supplier number. For each value of supplier name, there should be only one value of supplier number. But here Raj has a multiple supplier number, that is S1 and S3. So supplier name is not functionally determining supplier number, because you can see that for a given value of supplier name, that is Raj, we are getting multiple values of supplier number. Now let us find out the dependence between city and supplier number. For a given value of city, we are getting multiple supplier numbers, that is S1 and S2 in this case. So city is not functionally determining supplier number. Same way, for a given value of status, we are getting multiple values of supplier number. So status is also not functionally determining supplier number. So from this discussion, we can conclude that supplier number, which is the primary key of this relation, is functionally determining supplier name, city and status. While the reverse of this is not true, supplier name is not functionally determining supplier number. City and status is also not functionally determining supplier number. From this discussion, we can conclude that every primary key of a relation always functionally determines all other non-key attribute of the relation. Here primary key is S number and non-key attribute are supplier name, city and status. The primary key of the relation, which is S number, is functionally determining all other non-key attribute, that is S name, city and status in this case. So we can conclude that primary key of a relation functionally determine all other non-key attribute of the relation. This is all about this session. I request all of you to subscribe this YouTube channel to receive latest video tutorials on topics like data mining, machine learning, DBMS, Big Data, NoSQL and many more. To learn DBMS in a simplified way, you can join this online course on DBMS, which is available at Udemy platform. Simplified approach to DBMS is now available in Kindle format. You can download this ebook from Amazon platform. I have also created online courses on SQL, PL SQL and machine learning. All these courses are available at Udemy platform. You can join these courses to learn these concepts. I have also authored books on data mining and data warehousing, DBMS, NoSQL, Beginning with SQL and PL SQL for Beginners. All these books are available at Amazon platform. To read more about this, you can refer my website pratikbhatia.com. Thanks for watching this video.